here to announce that the DNC, the Democrat Party, is in collusion and obstruction with mainstream media, in this case NBC, for not bringing up the issue of reparations. Not a single question of reparations in this debate. Now, this was just the first night. Tomorrow will be the second night. We have a candidate that will be on the stage who has supported reparations for years, stated many, many times her support for this, and she's also given a dollar amount, although that figure needs to get a lot higher, but it's more than what these other candidates have done. So we'll see how it goes on the second night compared to the first night. But once again, the DNC, the Democrat Party, in collusion and obstruction with mainstream media, NBC News, for not bringing up the issue of reparations. And I was looking at some of the data at the results of the 2016 election, and now I'm convinced more than ever, as close as that race was and as close as 2020 is likely to be, and whoever the Democratic nominee is, it's likely to be someone who's going to be far more likable and seen as more favorable than Crooked Hillary. So the Democrat Party probably has a better chance of winning in 2020 than 2016. If you don't give us what we want, you're not going to get our voter turnout and participation. You're going to struggle to get that 80% plus of the ADOS community that you're going to need to beat 45. So keep playing with us. Keep on not taking us seriously. You think this is a game? If you don't give us what we want, we're not going to vote, and you're going to lose. I don't care if 45 wins. Oh well, four more years. Another racist in the White House, like what America has pretty much always had, probably with one exception. No reparations, no ADOS agenda, no vote. Simple as that. You better quit playing games, DNC, and you better get serious. Because if you don't meet our demands, you're not going to win.